What's up, guys? Your host Buffalo Bob here, and we're going to talk about some deadline moves that are going to be going on in the next few weeks. Right now, it's just speculation. We don't really fully know who's going to get traded and who might come to the Sabres and whatnot. We really don't know, but there have been some names being thrown around that I want to discuss. In fact, two names were brought up recently, and I want to bring my attention to you guys about what you guys personally think is going to happen here. So, there's two names in mind. It's Timo Meirer from the San Jose Sharks and Thatcher Demko from the Vancouver Canucks. These are two names that are being brought up here, and I want to bring it to your attention. So we're going to start with Timo Meirer first. So Timo Meirer is obviously now the big fish since being on the trade bait list pretty much everywhere from like TSN, RDS, Sportsnet, etc. Timo Meirer is like the top dog this year. And it's basically whoever signs him is pretty much a guarantee almost that he gets an extension and will play for that team for years to come. And the Buffalo Sabres have been linked to this as well with the New Jersey Devils, the Dallas Stars, the Boston Bruins, the New York Rangers. I was going to mention the Islanders, but they got Bo Horvat yesterday from the Vancouver Canucks. But yeah, it's just an interesting start. So Bo Horvat is already off the table. So Bo Horvat is gone. He's going to the New York Islanders, which is my hometown. And yeah, so it's going to be a very interesting deadline moving forward now, what happens to Bo Horvat. But Timo Meirer is an interesting case too, because right now Timo Meirer is having a great season thus far. But here's the thing. He's got 48 points in 51 games with 28 goals and 20 assists. But the minus 13 is a factor here. And, of course, for those who don't know, he's 6'1", 220 pounds, and he's a right winger. So, really, the guy hasn't even reached his prime yet. So, Timo Meirer is just scratching the surface. And, in my opinion, whoever gets Timo Meirer, they're going to be given probably the best opportunity to sign him. Because, for one, he's an RFA. And, two, whoever trades for him, it's probably going to be for like first round picks or like some prospects and maybe some veterans. There's real no straight answer what exactly San Jose wants, because normally the Sabres, as far as fans are concerned, they would be accustomed to selling. But for me, in this perspective, you want to be a conservative seller and a conservative buyer. Buffalo could do both this year, and they have a possibility of making the playoffs. So if they were to add Timo Meirer, I'm not against it, as I actually would love the Sabres to get Timo Meirer. But here's the thing. It's going to cost them. And the question is, what do you give up? Well, from what I read, there's a first-round pick that would be implied. And then there's a grade B prospect, maybe two, if possibility, and a player on the roster, which is very doable. So in my proposal to the San Jose Sharks, I would say the Sabres get Timo Meirer and defenseman Matt Benning, because why not? You don't have to go crazy on the blue line. Add a little depth, and I think that would actually benefit. But Matt Benning, I think, would be a really nice, you know, addition to this trade as well. And on top of all that, I would also, in that case, I would like for the Sharks to give up a fifth-round pick as well in the deal. So Meirer, Benning, and a fifth in 2023 to the Buffalo Sabres. And in my opinion, the Sabres will give up a conditional first-round pick in 2023, similar to what the Islanders did with the Vancouver Canucks to get Bo Horvat. And the condition of that deal, for those who didn't see it, was if the Islanders miss the playoffs, because right now they set themselves up to be a non-guaranteed team to make the playoffs, but if they sign Bo Horvat, they're going to be good long-term with his contract. But because he's a UFA and the Islanders somehow miss the playoffs, they have an option to reclaim their first-round pick for this year, but would have to give up next year's first. So really, this is a very big, you know, decision for the Islanders to make with Bo Horvat, because you give up Artur Rantu, which I hated, and then Anthony Beauvillier, all right, and that first-round pick. So this is a prime example of what I'm talking about. So do what the Islanders did with Bo Horvat. So give up that conditional first-round pick to San Jose. I would also give up in the likes of Noah Oslin or Isaac Rosen. I'm more open to giving up Oslin because they haven't really seen enough of him yet to really say this guy has a legit shot to make the team in like 3 years. So we'll find out what happens from there. But Noah Oslin, I'm going to say, so Oslin a first. I would also throw in Casey Mittelstadt as well. And I would throw in a maybe a third round pick as well. So that's what I would do for this trade alone, because you're getting yourself a young prospect, you're getting a middle six forward, you're getting a high first round pick and another pick, and then Buffalo would get Meyer, Benning, and that fifth round pick I mentioned earlier. So that's my proposal in this deal. And the Sabres would then immediately sign him to an 8-year extension that would pay Meyer around maybe $8.5 to $9 million. I mean, the guy deserves it. I mean, there's a reason why he's a hot commodity in the trade deadline this year. So you want to go out and get that kind of player. Buffalo's got a lot of scoring options, man, but it may feel like it's not enough. So go out and get yourself a guy like Timo Meirer. This guy would be a quote-unquote veteran. So I think to bring him in, I think would really benefit the team, and it would get the fan interest to go up again. So really, it would be a win-win for the Sabres. You know, I don't think they mind giving up the first-round pick, especially for a guy like Timo Meirer. He's arguably the best player available at the trade deadline. I mean, Bo Horvat would have been another option, but Bo Horvat's gone, so it doesn't really matter at this point. But Timo Meirer would be a huge hit for Buffalo right there if they were able to acquire him. And the other player I want to talk about tonight as well is Thatcher Demko. Now, Elliot Freeman brought this up today on the Jeff Marek podcast, and he said that he's heard that the Buffalo Sabres were one of the teams that could have interest in Thatcher Demko, because allegedly Thatcher Demko has people around him that are close to the situation that have said that he quote-unquote wants out of Vancouver. And I don't blame him. The Vancouver Canucks are a disaster. They desperately need to rebuild, and they desperately need to blow it up, because they already got rid of Bo Horvat. You're getting Artur Ratu and Anthony Beauvillier and that conditional first you got yesterday in the trade with the Islanders. So you got a nice start right there. And then despicably treating Bruce Boudreau like shit and then bringing in Rick Tocchet. So already it's not a good look for the Canucks. But for Thatcher Demko to be possibly available in a trade, I think this would be something that's worth looking at. If, let's say, for the sake of argument, you know, if like UPL gets hurt, God forbid, knock on wood, and Craig Anderson and Eric Comrie, all these guys are possible availability for a trade with the Canucks. So I think this would be a trade that makes more sense to make during the summer. But if they want to make a push for the future, this would be a good trade to do it. So let's take a look at Thatcher Demko's statistics. So Thatcher Demko hasn't really played a lot of games this year because he's been hurt. But Thatcher Demko has only played 15 games this year. And he has a 3-for-10 record with 2 overtime losses. And his save percentage is horrendous at .883. And his goals against average is 3.93. So really, Demko's just been having a very rough year with injuries and stuff like that, because that's going to be a big factor for the Sabres. Is, are they willing to bring on a guy like Thatcher Demko, who has the ability to be a starter in the NHL, but at the same time has injury concerns? So it wouldn't be so bad if, you know, if Thatcher Demko was fully healthy. I think if Thatcher Demko was fully healthy from beginning of the season to like now, I think the value would have went nuts on his marketing. But again, teams like the LA Kings, the Buffalo Sabres, and the Pittsburgh Penguins are all interested in Demko. LA is a possibility, but I don't see Vancouver trading him to a division rival. And it's not to say that it hasn't happened, because it's definitely have. But with the price that the Canucks are going to want, they might want some assets in return for him, because he's a pretty good goalie when he's healthy. I know a lot of people out west, like in Seattle or Edmonton or Calgary, will say, well, Demko's a bitch, so don't even be surprised if that's the case. Well, we'll see. But Thatcher Demko is a good goalie. He's serviceable. But could you imagine the 1-2 tandem of UPL and Thatcher Demko, and then give Devin Levi time to develop and then just get rid of Demko in a few years or flip him, whatever? I don't know. It's just something that's just really intriguing to me. That's all I'm saying. That would be a hell of a pickup for Buffalo if they're able to make this work. Because the Vancouver Canucks, like I said, they are just trying to fill up a roster. They're trying to tank for Connor Bedard. And that's the best way I can describe it. But what would a trade look like for Thatcher Demko? So for Demko, in my opinion, it's probably going to cost maybe a prospect and maybe one of the three goalies. So I'm going to say, for the sake of argument, that the Sabres put Eric Comrie in the deal. I'm going to say a third and a second in this pick as well. And I would also throw in Zemgus Girgensons as part of the deal as well. So Girgensons, Comrie, a second and a third to the Vancouver Canucks for Thatcher Demko and possibly Luke Shen. But that's my take on that deal. But I'm more open to just taking in Demko by himself. It really comes down to the asking price, because if the rumors are real of Thatcher Demko wanting out of Vancouver, then okay, then you have to start discussing it, because goaltenders in the NHL around the trade deadline very rarely get, you know, traded. And I think the last one, actually, that I think about it, the last one that was like a headline goalie who got dealt at the trade deadline from the, you know, the back of my head, I think the last one to actually do it was Ryan Miller, and that was almost 10 years ago. And Ryan Miller was obviously traded from the Sabres to the Blues with Steve Ott. We know the rest of that story. But no, it's just, we're not used to seeing, like, the Sabres fans are not used to seeing this, as far as the Sabres being in the conversation for one of the big fish at the trade deadline. Normally, they'd be sellers. But right now, I look at the Sabres as more being in the middle. It's not a guarantee they make the playoffs, but it's also a possibility that they miss it. But it could be a win-win in this case. So maybe getting both Timo Meirer and Thatcher Demko, I think, would really help the Sabres going forward. Because you bring in Demko to be a placeholder for Devin Levi when he fully develops. And then once that's settled, you bring in Levi, you sign him first, and then you let him develop in Rochester and then go from there. That's how I think that the Sabres should look at this. Because Devin Levi was one of the big pieces in that Sam Reinhart trade from a year ago, almost 2 years ago. So honestly, it's a big factor for the Sabres right now. And they need to make some smart moves. And maybe they don't have to make a trade. I mean, they can very well get Jacob Chikarin from the Coyotes, but it might cost them much. But those are just some names that were thrown around that I think that would really benefit the Buffalo Sabres. And they have the cap space to do it as well. So maybe giving up some of these players to bring in some more, you know, talented veterans like Thatcher Demko and Timo Meirer, that would benefit the Sabres a lot. So we'll see what happens. And, you know, it's the deadline. Anything can happen. So I think with that being said, let me know in the comment section below, who do you think the Sabres should get at the trade deadline? And what would you give up for one of these two guys? And if you don't agree with me, that's fine. You know, leave your comment down below, and I'd love to read them and have a debate and see what we have going. So with that, I'll talk to you guys later. Go Sabres.